So I think that I will show off my room. Brad did a little video of his room. So my room is in the basement. You come downstairs and the first thing I have is this little thing here that says you're entering the board game. I'm basically coming down to the board game room. My wife made that for me. So as I come downstairs, I'm not going to be able to do something on every game just because I have a little bit of a room here. Got some wall art here. Come down here. This is my two-player area right here. So you can see some two-player games here. Two-player only games, I should say, that are right here. And a little Lego thing, little Lego Angry Birds castle there. And D&D Attack Wing miniatures, because I used to be in a D&D Attack Wing. Then as you come over here, we have some more games. These are in no particular order, just, I guess, where they fit is where they sit. Some toys on the floor because my daughter, my six-year-old daughter, soon to be 6 years old, comes down here and plays with toys and stuff. So, but here's just a selection of games so you can get a better idea of what you can see for games. The kind of games that I have or particularly enjoy playing. And some of them are unplayed, a lot of them are played. You'll see here, some of them have 3D printed inserts, some of them don't, some of them will. That's, you know, kind of the idea of the whole, what I'll be contributing to the channel. At the very top, you'll see my number one all-time favorite game of all time, which is Bus, a splatter game. Just ironic that I'm also a transit bus driver, but I really do like the game, what it brings to it. It's a game that was released 20 years ago, over 20 years ago now. And some of the mechanics that are in it were revolutionary for the time, and a lot of games that are coming out now, basically you're seeing the mechanics come out and people are saying, ah, it's such a revolutionary mechanic, but Bus actually had that mechanic 20 years ago, so it's a really interesting game. Over here you'll see another one of my obsessions, which is Funko Pops, mainly only Star Wars, a lot of the Mandalorian ones. I started with the child Funko Pop, and then from there I went to other Star Wars Funko Pops, as you can see here. I have a couple of non-Star Wars ones, and they were just particularly because I just liked them. They're not really worth of any value. The Mega Man Gold one and the Manticore from Onward. I just really liked it. And of course, my Kool-Aid Man Funkoverse expansion. I don't have a base version of the game yet. I probably should so I can play it, but I really liked the Kool-Aid Man, so I really wanted it. So, and then top shelf, a couple of Vindication, the Kickstarter edition. So we go back over to this wall over here, and some more games. So, again, lots of games here, no particular order. It spans quite a bit here. Those two cases down there that you can see at the bottom, they're PhotoKeeper cases. Two of them, each one of them can hold, I think it's between 20 and 40 games, depending on the size of the games. One of them actually has like 30 some games in it because I have the pack of games in there. Games. So there's more games over here as you can see there. Lots of games over there. I'll get closer to that in a second there. The top of this shelf here, just a computer I'm trying to fix a power cord on. It's my 3D printing computer. So right now I'm using my other laptop for 3D printing. This is an older laptop that I've hooked up to a monitor in the 3D print room, which I'll show you shortly. A keyboard that I connect to my current laptop. When I'm doing streams, when I'm doing online gaming and stuff like that, I use that. There's a monitor here that I use for online gaming, along with another camera that I will be using for close-up shots. That's the C920 that I'll be using for overhead shots. Over in this corner here, just a bunch of different things for games. Some are cases or little tiny small containers to put in games that I got at the dollar store. Sleeves, baggies, and that little filing cabinet there. Bunch of some older games there that I'm just looking through. Scotland Yard, which is, you know, for a blast from my past. The game of Halifax. I live in Halifax, Nova Scotia. The Game of Nations, a coworker of mine lended it to me to take a look at. He wants to play it, so I'm going to give it a try. It's a really older game. I think it's from 1979, I think, was a print. Maybe wrong on that. Didn't know much about it. Over here, just a little temperature gauge and a humidity gauge so that I can control the humidity in the rooms. So I have an air conditioner dehumidifier in the other room so I can control it. Up here, some display games. Carcassonne of the City, which Brad, the other half of Meeple Paradise, really wants that. as it's a hard copy to get, especially the wooden version of the game. Some Spiel Carcassonne tiles that Brad brought back for me from Essen. Santorini, the Zeus edition, and just some longer games that I didn't put down there. The Carcassonne big box with a bunch of expansions. You'll see there's some more games over here. A bunch of games right here. Just pan through those games to give you an idea of the kind of games that I collect, play, enjoy. Probably went a little fast, so I'll slow down a little bit. I just realized that when I was looking at the video. So there's some more over there too. Just to show you the games I got there. Tripod right here, which I either will mount this camera to that I'm using right now when I'm doing talking headshots. Right now I'm using my my Joby to hold on to. Up here you'll see my second favorite game, Scythe, and all of its material. This is mostly an empty box, but I just keep it up there because it was the Art Connoisseur edition. Everything available for Scythe in here, except for the Metal Mechs. At some point in time, I'll be able to get those Metal Mechs. My Little Scythe, which is my daughter's game, she likes playing it. These are some upgrades of a game I recently got. I just haven't had a chance to unpack the game yet for Pacific Rails, done by a local company called Vesuvius Media. Just haven't had the chance to actually unpack the game and put everything in the box, which will probably happen this weekend. Some more games over here that I own. A lot of games. One of my favorite games over here. Another one of my favorite games here. You'll notice a train theme because I love train games. Haven't gotten to 18XX games, but there's a bunch of train games there. Some cool games down here. The really black one that you may not be able to make out is The Island of El Dorado. That's the, I guess, their legendary box, whatever it's called. The really super deluxe box. A lot of games through here. My forbidden game shelf here. Some games up there. So then the top here of this shelf, because we have another shelf here, got Brass, one of my favorite games, Brass Birmingham, love Lancashire as well. Also have the Iron Clays. I do play poker as well, which is why I have the 200 counters here on each side. And then I have a 200 wood box with the iron spades at the top, and then the iron clays at the bottom. And I've modified this wood box by adding, by buying the additional 2000K chips. This one here also was modified. So basically these two boxes together would make up what the 400 box was. And this was an extra one that I bought here because I wanted to have at least 600 chips. Of course, one of the stuffed animals from Root. Really should pick up the second one. Another shelf here. See here, so some of the games here. Another train game there. Emperial, which is a train game, essentially set. I think it's pick up and deliver. I haven't played it, just recently got it. It's set in the Argent of the Consortium universe, done by Level 99 Games. Pan Am, really good game. Root, really good game again. And the Hall of the Mountain King, the Isle of Cats, really good games. Cooper Island, really good game. Suburbia Collector's Edition, Kalis 1303, which is the new edition of Kalis. Really enjoy that game. Dinogenics Kickstarter with metal coins and all that other jazz. Quacks with the Geek Up bits. Gloomhaven, I'm going to try to solo it this winter, you know, when it's snowing and stuff like that. So I've been told I can solo it with two characters. I'm going to give it a try. Cartographer's, really awesome game. Heaven and Hell, I love it. Calico just got that today, and Fort just got that today. A couple of empty shelves at the bottom here to fill. And some play mats down here that you can't see because they're reversed, but it's the play mats for Dice Throne Season 2. So that is the games I own for now on these shelves here, as you can see. It's almost 500 games. And you'll see the center here, we have my table. This is my gaming table. So connected to my gaming table, similar to what Brad has, but I think Brad does have the arm. This is my Blue Yeti. With the Yeti caster arm. When I have people over to game, I take it down. But this is so when I'm doing online streams or when I'm playing with friends and I'm getting really active into the chats, I can actually use this, put on my headphones for no latencies, streaming and listening through here. This game table is a vaulted game table that was made locally. I'll try to open it up here. See. It's a vaulted game table. You can see. So when I play, I do that. There's a card well that's built into here. Right here, this is a card well to stick your cards in. Good sleeve cards. And then the back half here, we have a couple more shelves. There's a TV here where I do, where I watch some TV, but I also mainly watch how to plays. And then when I'm gaming, I'll put music in the background. These shelves here are actually, I run a local group by, which is how Brad and I first met and became friends. So what happens is I do it for two online stores and Kickstarters. So people for the two online stores ship to my house. We get free shipping through a group and they ship to my house. I unpack the packages. People will then ship, will then come and pick them up. So this is all organized and I have in my head how it's supposed to be organized. Brad, as an example, this is Brad's stuff here. So Brad, the other half of Meeple Paradise, this is all this stuff, ends right here. This is extra stuff here. Here's his geek outfits, the ones that I spoke about that I had in my copy of Quacks. We ordered it together. In this box here, he's got the, I'll put this up here, I'll have to squeeze it in there later. We have the Scythe rule book, the complete rule book, and he has the modular board in there. So I do these group buys and people come and pick them up. Brad, lives about 3 hours away, so him, I see him once a month, once every couple of months he'll show up and pick up his stuff. He can sometimes get a little bit of a gain on during COVID when there was a complete lockdown between our provinces. He was getting quite a bit of a collection, and then right now we're in an Atlantic bubble. So all of Atlantic Canada, New Brunswick where Brad is, Nova Scotia where I am, PEI, and Newfoundland, we're all created a bubble. So basically you can travel in those provinces, and there's no restrictions, there's no 14-day isolation. Anybody that enters into that bubble from outside has to have a 14-day isolation before they're allowed to travel within the bubble. These are my two games here. A little bit crooked here because one of my cats sleeps up here. Homemade dice tower here. The wood flick 'em up, and the wood junk art. Got a bunch of expansions in there. So now we're going to take a look at the 3D printers, which is what are we doing a lot of streams on. So we go to the unfinished part of the basement. Excuse the mess, but we go to the unfinished part of the basement. So here is one of the 3D printers. This is a Chiron. I need to fix this one. I'm having a bit of issues, but I think it's issues that I can fix. I just got to sit down and have some time. Print bed on this bad boy. 17 by 17 by 18 tall, I believe is what it is. So I can create some pretty big stuff there. This is the 3D print computer. Like I said, I have the laptop out there. It's usually hooked up to this. Just having an issue with the power cord. Maybe to buy a new power cord, figure out what's going on with it so I can be able to use it. Over here, we have an Anycubic i3 Mega S. Print bed is 8 by 8 by 8 tall, so I can do a few things on that. I don't have anything 3D printing right now because I've just had some projects that I finished, and I'll probably get some stuff going tonight. There's some 3D print stuff here that I'm doing for myself, doing an upgrade for Wingspan because somebody wanted the upgrade that I already printed for mine, so I gave them mine, and I'm pre-printing myself some bits. And you go over here, I have another Chiron right here. They're named, my kids named them Big Julie, which my daughter's name is Julie. The other one was Big Ron, and my son's name is Ron. They named them. This one recently printed last night. Printing face shields, there was a need locally during the height of wave one of COVID. People needed face shields, so I was actually providing them for free by donation, and I probably put out about 5,000 of them via this print firm that I was running down here. I had another printer that I sold because I didn't need five. I just had it running momentarily. So these are face shields. The reason why I printed some more was I had a fire department that wanted some. And then I recently bought a rotary tool, similar to a Dremel, just a no-name Dremel, because I wanted to see how they would help with my 3D printing to sand down some edges. And it would appear I need a face shield to prevent any dust from getting up in my eyes. So I printed off some face shields for myself and my wife. So when we use the Dremel, we can use the face shield. I just put them together. The other parts are in the games room there, but it's just a frame. They sit right on your head, kind of like this. Let's see if I can put this on. Put the camera. Focusing on another printer there, but can't seem to focus it on there, but the idea is that it sits on your head. Put it on there real quick. Sits on the head right there, and then you'll have the face shield, the piece of plastic that goes down here, and the piece of plastic just clips onto this. Then we focus over here. This is another Printo Uno. I was making some ear savers. These are for my own use and some people at work, because we're mandatory to have to wear masks when we're at work. So this is to get the strings off of our ears, clips onto each side to put them on our back. During the pandemic, I was, again, doing these for free. I was printing off a bunch, giving them away to nurses and doctors, healthcare workers, home care workers, firefighters, you name it. I put out probably close to 2,500 of these. I had two machines running them full time, and they were running about 17 every hour and a half. And I was about 2-3 months of doing this. So these are my printers down here. You'll see stock. This is some of my filament. I'm running a little bit low on filament. I need to start buying more. The reason I'm running low is obviously because of the face shields that I made. They had taken up a lot of the filament. But this is essentially where the 3D print magic is going to happen, and where you'll see some filming happen, but the majority of it will be showing you the outcome at the end of it. But that is essentially my 3D print area and my games room.